Fresno State.
We'll be kicking off, and I hope you're as ready as I am to get the second half underway.
Fielded at the 9.
He's tackled
at the 36-yard line.
For LSU, they slipped up in the first half and are actually trailing. For more, let's send it down to Aaron.
Well, to say the coach is upset would be an understatement, guys. In our meetings this week, he told us he felt like his team did not have a great series of practices, but hoped his guys would be able to turn it on come game day. Instead, it appears they may be ripe for the upset.
And for Fresno State,
the 2 sacks are something to build on in the second half. Brad?
Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards. From their own 44-yard line, second down. Brought down at the 47-yard line. First down pick up by the tailback.
You can see how comfortable this guy is with that football in his arms.
First and 10, ball on the 47. Henderson drops back to pass. Nice play across the middle. And he's tackled at the 35. It's first and 10. Ball on the 35. He looks to throw on first down. Moves up in the pocket. From the 35-yard line, it's second down. Drops back to pass. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 25. Here's the pass, broken up.
Well, that's one effective way to slow these guys down, getting a hand between the ball and the receiver.
Kicks up, and he got it. LSU ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. Oh, he got tattooed on that one. They'll start this drive at the 20. First down, 10 yards to go. Field. It was the defensive lineman that got a hold of him there.
You're not going to break many tackles when this guy gets his hands on you.
Reese, options out to the left.
I'll tell you what, for a defensive back, this kid is a sure tackler, and he showed it right there.
Third and 14 coming up here. Ball on the 15-yard line. Reese, back to throw, throws it, and oh, he dropped it.
This unit has quick hands, and they showed it there by knocking away the pass.
Herring awaits the snap. Oh, he got tattooed on that one. Well covered by the kicking team. He didn't go anywhere.
What I like about this play is that the guys stayed in their lanes and didn't allow the big play.
Excellent field position to start the drive.
Yeah.
And off to the back. Look out. To the 20. To the 10. And they finally make the stop at the 4. What a huge run by the tailback.
It's pretty obvious that this offensive line controlled the line of scrimmage that time. But did you see how this halfback eluded the defense?
First and goal from the 4. They're knocking on the door. Runs it and tackled in the backfield.
It's never good for a back's confidence to get tackled for a loss. But this guy knows that he's got to just keep at it and the holes will start to open up.
Second down at their opponent's 8-yard line. Gets to about the 5-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running back. Third and goal, and they can already taste the lead. Gives it up the gut. Touchdown, Tigers!
He's got a nose for the end zone. What more can you say? He wasn't giving up on that run until he was in for the score.
Now you see him, now you don't. A very impressive run, net 6. And they're looking to get 2 points here. And he's in for 2. A 4-play, 49-yard drive. And they've come away with 8 points. So the score now, 17-10. LSU to kick. He got all of that one. And he makes it out to about the 17-yard line. They'll start at the 17-yard line. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. Muhammad gains about 2 yards on the run. Second and 8. Ball on the 19. And he's taken down at the 27-yard line. 8-yard gain on the pass. That'll be good enough for the first down.
It's the protection up front that allowed this play to happen. The line controlled the rush, and it gave the quarterback an opportunity to deliver a very nice throw.
They'll go with the run once again. Makes it out to about the 36. Great job by the running back, and that's a gain of 9. That brings up second and one. Second and 1 coming up here. Ball on the 36. At the 36, the fullback back to the original line of scrimmage, and that's it. From their own 36-yard line, it's third down. Takes it, and he's tackled short.
They might have been able to catch the defense off guard with a play-action pass there, but by going to the ground, they didn't have much of an opening.
It's fourth down. They come out in a punt formation. Herring is the punter. And there's a penalty on the play. Let's see who it's on. That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 21. Gives it up the gut. Gets out to around the 35. From their own 35-yard line. First down. He unloads it. This one is incomplete. From their own 35-yard line. Second down. Looks to pass. Steps up and he's sacked for a loss. So the sack makes this third and very long. They go with the back, and he's not going to make it.
I actually liked the call, but it was really smart, disciplined play by the defense.
He punts it away, and it's a great kick. He fields the punt at the 16. They'll bring him down at the 20. Well, that was a great punt, and there was even better coverage on the return. First and 10, ball on the 20. He pump fakes. From their own 20-yard line, second down. Gets the toss and hammered.
From a defensive coordinator standpoint, it can really help out your scheme when you get excellent run support by the corner.
From their own 18-yard line, third down. Reese, back to pass.
The deflection prevented them from getting any yards, and now it's fourth down.
And that's it for quarter number three. Folks, we got a great game on our hands. Our score here in Baton Rouge, LSU 17, Fresno State 10.